Good morning, friends. Welcome back to the class. So in the previous lectures, many of the students are struggled in the domain questions. So they are requested, they insisted me to take this session again. So for you people only, I am taking this domain concept related questions in this lecture as a session 7. Remember, I am taking only those questions which are related to domain, right, where we need to find the domain of the functions as a session 7. So before getting to the questions, I have listed this here trigonometric functions, inverse trigonometric function and their respective domains. So if you remember, well and good. If not, so you can refer this checklist here, and from with the help of these two, then we are going to solve few questions. In each and every question, we are going to find the domain of the function. The function is given like sine inverse of 2x minus 3. What is the domain? Domain means the possible value of x where the given function is defined. I repeat, domain means the possible value of x where the inverse of this function, our given function, is defined. So that is meant by domain. So now we are going to find the possible values of x where the function is defined. Now, before start the any question, if it is sine inverse, if it is cos inverse or tan inverse, just refer the standard domain of the function. So if you just recall the domain of sine inverse x, what is sine inverse x domain? We have minus 1 to 1. It means whatever the value here involved, expression is involved in place of x, that range lies between what? Minus 1 to 1. So that is what I am taking here. So the domain of sine inverse x is minus 1 to 1. So definitely whatever the expression there in the question in place of x must lies between minus 1 to 1 only. So I am taking that first expression is 2x minus 3 is the expression whose value is lies between minus 1 to 1. That's it. Now, once we take this step and then simplify the expression to get the possible values of x, that is a process. Now see how to get the value of x. Simply by adding 3 on the all the parts. So if I am adding 3, what you will get? So 3 minus 1 will be 2 here, and plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled, 2x. 3 plus 1 is 4. Now to get the value of x, I will divide entire expression with 2. So it will be 1, it will be x, it will be 2. So now what are the possible values of x you got? It lies between 1 and 2. 1 and 2 are included. So finally your answer is x belongs to 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1 se lekar 2 tak, sare values included hai, including 1 and 2. So this is a way to solve the question where the domain is asked. What is the domain of sine inverse 2x minus 3? So first we'll go with the standard function. What is standard function? Sine inverse x. So sine inverse x domain is minus 1 to 1. It means that the possible values of expression involved is always minus 1 to 1 to define its inverse. Hence, whatever the expression is given, it must lies between minus 1 to 1 only, and then simplify the given expression by using the inequality concept. Inequality concept, right? So we are going to reduce this expression to get the possible values of x. That will be the answer. So domain of this function, sine inverse of 2x minus 3, is 1 to 2, where 1 and 2 are included. Now let's take some more questions, some more expressions to understand the concept in depth. Fine. Fine. So here I am taking another question, which is sine inverse x plus cos x or assignments, whatever you can take, no problem at all. So this is the expression. We need to find again domain of this function. So if you observe this question, there are two different functions are combined with the operator plus. So doesn't matter whether they are combined with plus or minus, if it is a binomial, we'll treat it as a combination of two different functions. First we'll find the domain of sine inverse x, we'll take the domain of cos x, and then we'll take the intersection of both the parts. Intersection, common area or common values of x which satisfying both the functions. So I'm taking the first part as here sine inverse x and second part as cos x. So simply we know that the domain of sine inverse x is minus 1 to 1, and the domain of, that is what we called as first part and the second part. So domain of cos x is every real number, you can see from here also. So hence now we need to take the intersection of these two values. So definitely what is the domain of the function? So let us, you may also consider this as f of x to write the domain. So you may write it as f of x, let the function is f of x, okay. So domain of the given function, so domain of f of x is the combination of these two means their intersection. So minus 1 to 1 intersection real numbers. So definitely your answer would be what? The intersection of every real number and minus 1 to 1 is minus 1 to 1 only. So this is the answer, final answer, which satisfy both the functions. Hence it satisfy the entire function. Hence it would be considered as the domain, means possible values of x of f of x. So it's very clear, very simple to understand. Just you need to remember these two set of formulas where the domain plays important role. Okay. Now next I'm taking one more question to understand the same. Sine inverse x plus sine inverse 2x. Now see, again I am consider this as, let us say, the function f of x, right? Now I need to find the values of x where, now which satisfying the entire function, that is we called as, in short, domain. Okay, so what is the domain of sine inverse x? That is minus 1 to 1, so it is a direct straightforward formula again. And then sine inverse 2x, what is the expression we have? 2x. So we need to simplify further. So first we'll take sine inverse x as a first function, this as second function, we'll solve individually, and then we'll take intersection of both the answers. So first I will take the, what is the domain, what is the possible values of sine inverse x is minus 1 to 1, I'm directly writing. And for second expression, what we have, expression as 2x, but whatever the expression is given in the inverse function, it lies between minus 1 to 1 only, that is for damn sure. So hence, for second part, I can say the 2x, the expression which is given, it must lies between minus 1 to 1 only. So hence, to get the value of x, I need to divide the entire expression with 2. So hence, minus 1 by 2, 2x, 2, 1 by 2. So what are the possible values of x? X I got here, x is belongs to minus 1 by 2 to 1 by 2, minus half to plus half, both are included. So this is the answer of second part. And first part answer we have minus 1 to 1. Now we need to combine both the answers to get the final answer. That is what domain of the function f of x is just the first answer intersection the second answer. Okay, first answer is what? Minus 1 to 1 intersection minus half to half, and you might get the answer. So the intersection portion is what? Minus half, 2 plus half over. It's so simple. So now you have understood how to deal with a question where the two or more than two expressions are involved. So if there are three expressions, we may take first, second, third part, find individually the domain of each part, and then combine all these three means what? Ki intersection of the three answers, nothing else. So it doesn't make any difference whether it is a plus or minus. It's just an operation to combine both the functions. So it doesn't make any difference whether it is a plus or minus. Answer would be remains same. Fine. Now I can take one more question where the simplification needs some technique. Okay, let's see. Right. I'm taking one question here. What we have? We find the domain of sine inverse of under root of x square minus 1. Let us see. So now how to deal with? Again, the same concept is same. The way of thinking, way of solving is also same. The only difference is the in between some simplification techniques you require, nothing else. Now I am doing the same one. So it is the form of sine inverse x. So whatever the x, whatever the expression, its value is lies between minus 1 to 1 only. Hence, it must be start like this, whatever, to find the domain. Minus 1 to under root of x square minus 1 value lies between plus 1. Now to simplify, to get the possible values of x, I need to simplify this part. First, I need to eliminate under root. That can be obtained by what? Squaring on both the sides. So if I do the squaring on both the side, it becomes plus 1. It is already 1 square is also 1 only, minus 1 square is also 1. So what we say here, so basically you may write this as, it means that square karne par kya hoga? Its value is reduced to what? Ki 1 and x square minus 1 and 1. So finally what you will say here, x square minus 1 is lies between 1 to 1. So if I add 1 on both the side, what you will get the answer as, see here. So if you do the squaring on both the side, so square of a number, remember here the important point I am discussing here, square of a number is never negative. If I do the square root of that, square of the given function, so definitely the range minus 1 to 1 after squaring the minus 1 to 1 range is reduced to what? Let's see. If it is minus 1, it is plus 1, it is 0. So for initially the function lies between minus 1 to 1, but after squaring that value becomes value lies between the positive range. It means that range is reduced to what? 0 to 1. This is the actual concept. So based on that, this inequality is reduced to what? It lies between 0 to 1. So remember this technique, wherever you are doing the square of the numbers, that negative range to positive range is involved, then you can cut that negative range, because that after squaring that value lies in the positive range. So negative range can be eliminated. So this is a technique you need to remember, and then you can go with the regular process. So now to get the value of x, what I will do here, I will add 1 on both the side, all the sides. So if I add 1, so it will be 1 less than x square is less than 2. Now to get the value of x, I need to do the square root again. So by doing the square root of positive number is positive only, so there is no need to change other sign here. So under root, if I take under root on all the sides, under root of 1 is 1 here, because again because it's a square, so we are ignoring the negative signs, and x under root 2. Now if any value of x lies between two numbers a and b, then the possible values of x, I'm writing it as a formula, you may use this formula to get the final answer. See, Remember, this is the most important case where you are dealing with a less than x less than b. If a less than x less than b means x is lies between two numbers a and b, where a is smaller than b, a is smaller than b, then x is belongs to minus b comma minus a union a comma b. So please remember this formula directly to get the answer. So you may also think how it can be possible. There is a theory behind it. इस फॉर्मूला को हमें लेने के लिए जस्ट वी नीड टू ब्रेक दिस टू पार्ट्स मींस फर्स्ट विल टेक वन इज लेस देन आर इक्वल टू एक्स देन विल टेक एक्स लेस देन आर इक्वल टू रूट टू एंड देन विल सॉल्व बोथ द इनइक्वालिटीज टू गेट द फाइनल आंसर सो दैट इज अ टाइम कंज्यूमिंग प्रोसेस सो इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग दैट आई कैन यूज दिस फॉर्मूला टू गेट द फाइनल आंसर डायरेक्टली वेर एवर एक्स लाइज बिटवीन टू पॉजिटिव नंबर्स लाइक ए एंड बी where a is less than b, then you can directly use this formula. So now I can get the final answer as x belongs to, in place of a we have 1, in place of b we have, this is a, this is b. Now use this formula to get the answer. So answer is minus root 2, 2 minus 1 union 1 to root 2 over answer. So this here we are using as a formula. So there are two critical points we have learned in this question is wherever the under root terms are there and we need to do the squaring on all the sides. While doing this, remember if the negative range is there, that is being eliminated because that value comes under the positive range. So now from minus 1 to 1, it's reduced to 0 to 1. And then do the simple algebra, whatever you're doing. Now once you get the value like x is lies between a to b, then that x possible values of x lies between the minus b to minus a union a to b. It's a simple standard derived formula we are using readymadely to get the answer, nothing else. Fine. So I hope it is clear to you. So now we'll take some more questions where you will see the technique, just like here, technique of simplification. So I'm taking one more question here. Sine inverse of what we call as x square. Or you may also take minus x square to become more complicated expression, nothing else. So whatever the expression involved, it lies between minus 1 to 1 only. So I'm just starting with that only. So minus 1 x minus x square is lies between plus x. Now first to get the values of possible values of x, I need to simplify the expression. So first I need to eliminate minus sign here. So I'm multiplying with minus sign. You know that when I multiply with minus 1, then ultimately inequality sign will get reversed. So it becomes what? Positive 1. Inequality sign will interchange. Interchange minus 1. So inequality sign is also interchanged here. This negative quantity becomes positive quantity. And this x square value is lies between minus 1 to 1. It means simply you can say a square of a number is never negative. Square of a number is never negative. Hence the range will lies between what? Reduced to what? 0 to 1 only. So I can write it lies between 1 greater than or equal to x square greater than or equal to 0. Other way to speak is what? 0 less than or equal to x square less than or equal to 1. Now you may also speak like what are the possible cases here. So if you take that again by taking the square root on both the side, what you will say here ki under root of 0 is 0 only and under root of x is x only, under root of 1 is 1 only. So now again the form of a to b form, so I can directly write the answer. Possible values of answer is what? 0 to what? You can write minus 1 to 0 union 0 to 1. So instead of saying this, I can also write the same expression that x is belongs to directly minus 1 to 1, because here the end of this interval is the start of this interval, so both are combined, are joined. Hence I can combine the entire range to get the final answer. So this is what the x value is lies between minus 1 to 1. So I hope it is so simple. Again, the learning point is, once you multiply the with the expression inequality with negative quantities, are dividing the negative with the negative quantities, inequality will get reversed. First point. Second point, once you square obtain the square of a number, that negative range will be eliminated. So this entire range minus 1 to 1 is reduced to 0 to 1. So keep this point very clearly in your mind. So after that, we just we do the square root on the both the side, and then we'll get the simplified form, and we are using the formula which we were using in the previous question also. So once you use this, you will get the final answer like this. But still here, 0 and 0 are same, means end and the initial of these two ranges are same. It means these two are connected with 0, hence there is no gap between these two ranges. Hence it is counted as minus 1 to 1 directly. So I can write the simplified answer as minus 1 to 1. Hope so it is very clear to you. Now let's take the another question to understand the concept very clearly. So question number 6 in the sequence, I'm taking like 2 times of cos inverse 2x plus sine inverse x. Now see, it's so simple. I can divide this as first part and the second part. For the first part, whatever the expression involved, right? So that 2x, so cos inverse x range, sorry, domain is what? Minus 1 to 1 only. So hence the expression, whatever the expression given for the first part, it must lies between what? Minus 1 to plus 1 only. So now I will solve for x. Right, so dividing the entire expression with 2, so minus 1 by 2, okay, x less than 1 by 2. So finally I got the answer as it lies between minus 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. Right, this is the number 1. Now for the second part, I don't think it must be it need to be discussed, because sine inverse x means x lies between minus 1 to 1 only. So it's a standard formula. Now I can get the final answer just by taking the intersection of these two values. So final domain of the function f of x is, what you will say, the first answer intersection second answer. Doesn't matter whether it is a plus or minus, doesn't matter what are the coefficients of the functions. See, there are two things. It doesn't make any difference of the domain, whether it is a coefficient, maybe a positive, negative number, whatever. It doesn't make any sense. Here also plus or minus doesn't make any sense. Answer will be remain same. So hence 1 and 2 ka answer ka combination object karte, in dono ka jo intersection hai, wo hai minus 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. So this is the final answer. So here in this question, the learning point is, again, there are two functions. I took the two different functions separately. I will solve for x and then I will take the intersection of both the answers to get the final domain. So it doesn't make any difference whether it is a plus or minus between the two or more than two functions. First point. Second point is, coefficient of the sine inverse x or cos inverse x, whatever, this coefficient, numerical coefficient, doesn't make any difference in the answer. Remember this thing. So don't bother about this 2, 3, whatever it is there in the question. So this is all about the domain. Now I'm taking one or two more questions to understand. I will take some other t ratios, right, instead of sine and cos. So I would like to take now the question number 7 in a sequence, 7 in a sequence, that is cot inverse x plus cot x. So this is the inverse function, this is a trigonometric function. So what is the domain of the cot inverse x? Is every real number. And what is the domain of cot x function? Every real number, every real values except the value of n pi. So here the domain of the first part, so domain of the first part, domain of first function is x is belongs to any real number. First part is done. And then domain of the second part is what? X is belongs to every real number except the multiples of pi, right? Where n is belongs to z. That is every integer. Now, you know that there are two different standard functions, hence their domains are different. But to get the final answer, that is a combined answer, so you need to take their intersection. And what is the intersection you will get? So definitely the smaller one is this. So intersection of first and one, that is now the domain of first answer, intersection the second answer, first answer, intersection second answer. So what you will get? That is the intersection of every real number and real number minus this would be this. So final answer is r minus n pi comma n belongs to z. So final answer is this. Over. So it's so simple to understand. Now I will take the one more question to understand clearly. Question number 8 in a sequence I am taking. See. Question number 8 in a sequence I am taking. Second inverse x minus tan inverse x. So it's now the difference. So does it make any difference here whether you are, it is a combined with minus sign or they are combined with plus sign. So we'll take the domain of second inverse x, domain of tan inverse x, and we'll take the combination of both, that is intersection of both. So I am writing directly here. Ki what is the domain of second inverse x? So I am writing the domain of second inverse x is what? Ki every real number except what we call here. You can see here formula list. Every real number minus 1 to 1, minus 1 to 1, intersection. Domain of tan inverse x, domain of tan inverse x. What is the tan inverse x domain is? Every real number. So simply the combination here. So their intersection will be what? This is the domain of second inverse x, this is the domain of tan inverse x, then their intersection will be r minus minus 1 to 1 over. So in books there are several ways they are expressing the same. Isko hum alag alag tarike se express kar sakte, meaning would be same. Every real number, from every real number we are eliminating this range. It means that the possible values of x, the possible values of x is either greater than or equal to 1 or less than or equal to minus 1. So this is one way to speak. The same answer can also be written as x nothing but it lies between minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. See, the same answer can be written in a various forms, but the answer remains same. Okay, so no need to bother about ki sir answer is written like this but we got the answer like this, the meaning will be same. Now we'll take one more question. Very small. One or two mark question only can be framed based on the domain here. Now in a sequence, ninth question I am taking here, we have sec inverse of 2x minus 1. So this would be the last question in the discussion, right? So sec inverse of 2x plus 1. Now what we have if it is a second verse x, so second verse x domain would be what? R minus minus 1 to 1. So what does it mean? Whatever the expression involved, sec inverse and cosec inverse, means that expression a value is doesn't lies between minus 1 to 1. Iske beech mein nahi hoga, matlab minus 1 se less than hoga ya 1 se greater hoga. It means 2x plus 1 value is either it is less than or equal to minus 1, or 2x plus 1 value is greater than or equal to 1. So this is the possible values of x. Now, so this is a beginning step to start with sec inverse and cosec inverse. Remember, so minus 1 se ya to less hona chahiye ya to 1 se greater hona chahiye. There are two possibilities. Now we'll solve the two individual quantities to get the final answer. Now see, then to solve for x, just like an equation only we can solve. So 2x is less than or equal to minus 2, so it implies that x is less than or equal to minus 1. And or what we called as x or 2x is greater than or equal to 0, x is greater than or equal to 0. So now x may be 0 or greater than 0, or x may be minus 1 to minus infinity, minus 1 se kam. So I can also write this expression as x belongs to, what does it mean, minus infinity to minus 1, or means union, 0 or greater than 0, it means that 0 to positive infinity. So I am just expressing this inequality in terms of interval. So there are several ways to express the answer, but meaning would be same. You may also leave the answer here, but you may also want to express in interval form, you may express. So this would be the final answer. So this is the answer for this question. So hope so it is very clear to everyone. As you insisted me to take this domain concept again, so for you people only, as a session 7, I'm just I took this domain class concept by taking maximum possible cases to understand the concept. So hope you will be getting this concept very clear by watching this video multiple times. So just keep on doing in a worksheet. Along with this video, today I am going to upload one worksheet to practice this domain concept. So that will include maximum 15 sums, including these questions. So no need to worry. Along with the answers, I will upload one document to practice. So just take care of yourself and be happy, be healthy.